We started dreaming about producing Banner back in late 2013. And with this album, we really dreamed about taking our time with the music, producing the songs, cutting them up, redoing them if we needed to. We also wanted to record the album live at our Desperation conference that we have every year at New Life. And this whole process started in a small demo studio that we have at New Life, where we produce what we call piano vocal demos. In this process, we would create tracks that ranged anywhere from just pianos and vocals, all the way up to full pre-production tracks, where we would really work on the lyrics of the songs, the maps, and the chord structures.
Check.
You getting that?
Yeah, I'm getting that. I'm telling you, it was really quiet, now it's loud.
You ready?
Could be the track too, super hot.
All right, let's go. Let's go. Sing your song.
Jonathan Moose was mainly in charge of this process, and he did an incredible job of laying the foundation for what a lot of these songs would become. This eventually led us into an extremely busy season of touring around the country, plugging into our church here in Colorado, and pre-production with our good friend and producer, Michael Rosbeck.
There's a camera around. Like, I just have to be like, ah!
We'd spend the next few months in and out of the studio with Michael in between trips, and this really allowed us to dive even further into what these songs were going to sound and feel like. We had a lot of fun pushing ourselves musically with these songs while trying to keep them still singable and really worshipful. We had so many amazing moments watching these songs come to life, and there was a real sense of excitement about what they could become, especially when we were leading them at the conference. There's a fragrance, it's filling up the sky. It is worship, it's the sound of flesh feeding. It's the offering, it's the movement of a love to break open. There's a thunder. The next step in the process would be to figure out how we were going to pull this all off in a live setting. So in between trips, serving at the church, and studio time, we started putting together rehearsals with the whole band. The rehearsals came with their own set of challenges because we were now trying things we'd never tried before with the music. We're using analog synths, new ways to run our backing tracks, and new ways to connect videos and other visuals to the music to really create a full experience for all the kids that were about to come worship with us at the Desperation Conference. We were also having to have hard conversations about things like cutting songs that people really believed in. And on top of all this, most of the band was pretty exhausted from the last 4 months of touring, recording, and in many cases holding down full-time jobs back at home. Needless to say, this made for a pretty rough start to the rehearsals. Even with all of these dynamics going on, there was still a lot of anticipation for what these songs were doing. As we saw them get out of the studio and into our church, it was amazing to see them come to life and impact people at New Life before the conference even got here. So of course, we all pushed through. Over the next few weeks, we were able to really dial in the live sound, but we continued to write and record new songs and tweak with the songs that we had already finished. We also worked on gang vocals, as well as a bunch of the video elements that we would include in the live night. This process continued until just days before the live recording. And when the conference finally came, it exceeded all of our expectations. There is no way to make a way. singing Jesus. You've always been you, Jesus. It's always is you, Jesus. And always will be. Almost a full year after we began the process of creating Banner, I started to sift through the footage and the memories and the songs that are all contained in this little album that sits on a shelf after so much work. And so I compiled all of this footage, not just to let people in on our process, but really importantly for all of us in the band, so that we can remember. Remember all the hard work that we put in, how much fun we had, and remember how these songs and this album changed us all.